in these reports to educate the candidates so that they can be supportive after school if they win citywide office. And on the third point, I referenced this before, but I'm just reiterating it here, because you can share after school data with your mayor and your key city leaders at any point. It doesn't need to be only as part of a lights on after school celebration. We've seen that data on needs is really hard to ignore, especially if you have it depicted on a map, and can often get a citywide conversation going or take it to the next level. So talking about needs, you have an opportunity to encourage your mayor or school superintendent to write an op-ed about those needs and share what the city and school are doing to tackle it, to help the city thrive. New candidates can also discuss what their new campaign promises are. If they're incorporating after school as part of their platform and their agenda, this is another opportunity for them to write something publicly about that. And again, these op-eds can reference these national reports to help bring that national slant to the article and show how your city is part of a national movement of cities moving in this direction towards collaborating and creating a coordinated after-school system. Next slide, please. So I just wanted to mention, we have updated this report slightly, the executive summary, and we've made new copies. So we have a nice set of executive summaries in our office. And as you're holding key meetings with municipal officials, feel free to contact us to let us know if you would like a few copies to present at your meetings, to hand to elected officials, to hand to candidates. We'd love to help you support your efforts in that regard. Definitely, we see it as a good case-building report. Next slide. In terms of our MIS toolkit, we have also updated this on our website. We'll be updated soon. We also have a number of executive summaries available here to really help leaders think about how a management information system can help coordinate information and data about after-school programs and link it with schools to really begin that conversation about outcomes and impact. Wanted to highlight that we have been developing a cost calculator. I'm really excited about this. This cost calculator is going to help you get an average estimate on what an MIS may cost you depending upon your needs, how many program sites you have, and the type of functionality you're looking for it to play. So this will be up on our website and will be ready in about a month or so. So stay tuned, and we'll be sure through this network and our other networks to let cities know about this cost calculator. Next slide, please. Another wonderful opportunity is NLC's Institute for Youth Education and Families Summit on Your City's Families. We will be in Seattle November 12th through 14 with city leaders around the country who are working on these issues. We hold this summit every 2 years, and it's the country's largest gathering of municipal leaders. So we'll be really diving into a lot of these issues around after school and many other issues that affect children and families. So we're really excited about this opportunity and invite you to join us. And the registration link is there, and you can find that on our website. We plan to have a few networking opportunities to talk about what cities are doing in their system building work as part of our After School Policy Advisors Network, which we call APAN. Next slide. And then just to wrap up, we have a few more really exciting things that can help support your work. NLC has been working to create a national video on after school that focuses on the mayoral and council member voice and why after school is so important from their perspective. So this is a unique new video that you can share with your leadership, and many of your mayors are in it, and we thank you for helping us get their video clips to us. And so you can use this video to share with your leadership and have them hear from their peers. We always believe there's no harm in a little friendly city-to-city competition, and mayors listen to other mayors. So we will be launching this at our summit in Seattle. We'll be posting it online, and we'll be making it public for anyone to use to make the case for after school in their city and for why city leadership is such a critical component. We also hope to have a version that will allow cities, statewide after school networks, and others to use it as a public service announcement to promote their specific after-school efforts. Lastly, many of you are already part of our APAN group, but we encourage the rest of you to join or to re-sign up if you haven't participated in a while or if you didn't respond to our recent survey to officially rejoin. We're making it more streamlined, timely, and much more engaging to provide city leaders with multiple ways to find information with an APAN Facebook page, LinkedIn page, and we'll be doing a lot more with social media. So contact me directly to express your interest, and we'll send you information on how to join. So I want to thank everyone for your time, and NLC looks forward to supporting your efforts on any and all of the fronts that I've mentioned. I'll turn it back over to you, Jennifer Lerner.
Thank you so much, Bella, and what a great set of resources that you had to share with everyone. I have one additional resource that I do want to share with folks today. The nominations for the MetLife Foundation After School Innovator Awards are due very soon on October 14th. We encourage you to nominate those from your city who might qualify for one of these awards. In particular, the first category is very near and dear to the heart of system building's work. So I encourage you to think about nominating a program that's been using data to advance quality, or of course, nominating anyone in any of the categories. Either way, the winning program will receive a cash award and, of course, significant media attention and reference in many forthcoming publications. In addition, as we mentioned at the beginning of this webinar, this is the first webinar in our dedicated year of follow-up for the cities that attended last February's Better Together conference. Hopefully, you've already received our first bi-monthly e-blast, which will point you towards new resources and upcoming events, and we encourage you to forward the e-blast to others in your community to join this network. In addition, we'll be hosting a number of other events, including webinars and other online learning opportunities for you to learn and speak with each other. We want to highlight an upcoming fall webinar on the forthcoming messaging toolkit from the Collaborative for Building After-School Systems, or CBAS, as well as some of the other opportunities we have in the coming year. And finally, I want to thank today's presenters. It was a fabulous webinar, and we really appreciate your willingness to share your resources and your experience. We look forward to hearing about the Lights On After School in many of your cities. And like I said, we will be circling back to you with questions that we were unable to answer during today's webinar. Again, thank you to the Wallace Foundation, After School Alliance, and the National League of Cities. And finally, to all of you, we encourage you to fill out the webinar survey as you exit today's webinar. Thanks again for your attention.